knew it. I knew it. Switch up. That's crazy switch up. I got to pull back on that. That is really, oh man. I was expecting something, but not that. Hello, and welcome to another episode of Into the Music. I am Greg, and that is my buddy, my amigo, Chris.
I think that does mean buddy. Okay, but we'll get, we can be bilingual.
Right. Now, don't blush. So, so Chris, what do you got for me tonight?
Okay, I've got a band that we've covered a song of theirs so far. We reacted to one.
If there is something, I think, right?
Right, right. And I reacted to that. You had heard it. I reacted to it. So this one I've heard. You haven't heard it yet. It's called Mother of Pearl. Okay. And just go ahead and listen, man. We'll talk about it.
All right, cool. So on the screen, it says it's a crazy scene. It's indeed a crazy sound that just came blaring out. I got to process that. Let me start over. That's crazy beginning. Just have all these crazy vocals coming in here and there and just layered. With the last one that we did for Roxy Music, that one had twists and turns. It started off kind of country-ish, and then it took a turn, took another one. So I'm wondering if there are transitions here, switch-ups, that are awaiting me that I don't know about yet. So let's see. Let's continue. Have you a future? Get the guitarist's name for Roxy Music, please. In your comments, please let me know who he is. He's fantastic. He really is. He was amazing on that first song that we did. I knew it. Switch up. That's crazy switch up. I got to pull back on that. That is really, oh man. I was expecting something, but not that. Well, I've been up all night again. Party time wasting is too much fun.
looking for love in a looking glass world. It's pretty hard to find. Oh, mother of pearl, I wouldn't trade you for another girl. Divine intervention, always my intention, so why take my time? I've been looking for something I've always wanted but was never mine. But now I've seen that something just out of reach, glowing very holy grail. Oh, mother of pearl, lustrous lady of a sacred world. Thus even Zarathustra, another time loser, could believe in you. With every goddess a let down, every idol a bring down, it gets you down. But the search for perfection, your own predilection, goes on and on and on.
I mean, I was trying to follow the lyrics. I'm not. This is kind of too abstract right now for me. I mean, certain lines, almost everything is kind of cool just by itself. But man, this is like the vibe on this. This was is just so good. This is just so good. So this vibe is just fantastic. I wish I could pull back, but the song is long enough. So I'll try to actually finish out without any more stops.
But you are my favorite, and a place in your heart, dear, makes me feel more real. Oh, mother of pearl, I wouldn't change you for the whole world. You're highbrow, holy, with lots of soul melancholy shimmering. The plastic you. Korea girl cover exposed, and another slips right into view.
Oh, that's pretty.
Oh, looking for love.
I know, I promised, I said that I wouldn't stop, but it just, the guitar, I mean, just the instruments that are going on here, that they come in, come out, just right there. There was some sort of, like, you know, vocal, like, you know, just taking it out. There's that guitar that's just like that rhythm guitar. It just keeps like, along with the piano. The piano's just got that groove kind of. It's really hard for me to articulate it right now. I'm loving this song. Like, I am truly, I have fallen in love heads over heels instantaneously with this song. I'm going to be listening to this over and over and over and over and over and over and over after this.
In a looking glass world, it's pretty hard for you. Few throwaway kisses, the boomerang misses, spin round and around. Fall on feather bed quilted, faced with silks of the stuff I dirt down. Just give me your future, we'll forget your past. Oh, mother of pearl, submarine lover in a shrinking world. Oh, lonely dreamer, your choker provokes a picture of cameo. Your detached world.
that a horn?
Oh, mother of pearl, I wouldn't trade you for another girl. Oh, mother of pearl, I wouldn't trade you for another girl.
I'm speechless. I truly am speechless. I really am. I absolutely love that song. And I can't believe that I've never heard that song before. Like, I've never heard that song. Wow. This is great. This is, like, really great. It's like Christmas Day. Brand new present. Can't wait to, like, play with it, you know, over and over and over and over and over.
And I am back. All right. I'm good. Helicopter flying away.
Yeah.
Chopped me right off. Nice landing right in the chair.
That's pretty good.
Mother Pearl. Mother Pearl. Gorgeous, beautiful. It's just another one that I've listened to just recently. That I'm just shaking my head. How do I not know this song? It was similar to the one that you reacted to, If There's Something. Well, because the transitions, because I was expecting, what was really interesting about Mother of Pearl is that they flipped it around.
Oh, it was like two different songs, really.
Well, yeah. But
yeah, put together, yeah.
But in the beginning, you know, and in the beginning, it was like rocking, blaring. It was like, and the guitar's going crazy. And I remember the song I gave you, If There Is Something, where it started off country-ish, and then it twisted here, and then there. Right. And
a lot of unexpected.
And so I knew there was some transition going on. That's where this was different, where, you know, it just started off strong. It just came right out of the gate, just blaring. And the guitar was crazy. Do you know the name of the guitarist for this band?
I don't.
All right, so I did ask Roxy.
I don't know a lot about the personnel.
Please.
I only know the names of two members.
You know, the song
members, actually one of them wasn't in the band when they did this anymore. So
the song that we dropped, If There Is Something, you know, a week back or whatever, that's actually gotten a lot of comments. And so there are Roxy Music fans out there. And so we would ask you, please, like, give us information on the personnel. You know, I mean, Brian Ferry is just a given. Okay. Brian Eno, you know, he was with the band for a while there. He's a given. Okay. And yet who's that guitarist? I want to know the guitarist name. He was amazing. And then it switched. And it just switched into this, you know, where they had it like, you know, 90 miles an hour, and they just kind of, and it was like the windows were down, but I guess you could have the windows down 90 miles an hour. But I mean, it was just like, I'm picturing the arm is out, you're driving in the country. I don't know. And you just, everything around you is just, the scenery is just cool to look at. Oh, I've never seen that. That's cool. The vibe was so cool. It was just cool, chill, cool.
Yeah. Yeah.
And the lyrics that he was throwing, because there was a lyric video, all right? And I could just tell that everything is abstract. You know, almost every line was interesting just by itself, you know, but I don't know what the story was that he was trying to tell. If he, you know, Ferry was really good at like throwing lyrics, you know, just crazy.
Yeah,
lyrics
I was trying to interpret it too. And,
like maybe every lyric was a story upon itself.
It's hard to.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, it's hard to get a concrete explanation for the lyrics.
Right. I just wonder. Anyway. This is one of those where the band came up with this melody. You know,
melody was fantastic. It's one that was sticking in the head for a while.
Yeah. And he just came to the studio and said, what are you guys working on? And I'm just, you know, and then just all these lines just flying through. I mean, that's just my speculation. I mean, I'm probably dead wrong, but he could have laid down a whole poem here. And they said, okay, we'll actually put the music to that. But please tell me, because it's fascinating, because the music is so good. It's so, I mean, I have that song, This Is Rare. You know, I've done so many reactions now, right? We've done like 40. I mean, you've done some. But out of all of them, I mean, I could tell you this one, like, it's in my head right now. And it we just did a reaction, you know, a little while ago, mm-hmm. Achilles Last Stand, and as great as was at that was, as that was, this song was kind of like, it was banging the door open and trying to come in my head. It was like crazy. This song was so good. It was brilliant. It was good. Ferry's voice is excellent. The lyrics were sort of imagery, whatever, and that was really interesting. And so
That's what I get out of their lyrics too. So I don't really care about the concrete interpretation.
Yeah.
The concrete meaning.
What do you know about this song?
I don't. I just remember that I had I had a greatest hits album of theirs, you know, as when I was a teenager.
Yeah.
And mainly I listened to that. I never owned one of their regular albums. So this was one of the songs on it, and I always remembered the melody from the slower part.
Yeah.
The second part. It's instantly recognizable.
Mother of Pearl. It's just yeah.
Yeah, it flows nicely.
Flows not. Yeah.
I'm so glad you liked it, man.
Yeah. Yeah.
We'll definitely do some more of their stuff. We'll probably get more requests for their stuff.
I'm very excited, you know, because you know, we did Led Zeppelin, Achilles Heel, same night. This one's different. Achilles Last Stand.
Well, it is his heel they're talking about, right?
I'm a heel for not knowing the song. But
why his heel was the only vulnerable part of him?
Why?
Because think about the Achilles heel. Think about on a baby. Babies have fat little ankles, but you know, think on a person that you know you can grab, you can pinch that tendon
and
hold the person upside down. You have to have a very strong, you know, arm to do it. But so his mother, I can't remember what her name was, dipped him in some kind of liquid that made him invulnerable. So but where she had her fingers, that stayed dry when she dipped them in. I think he got killed by an arrow in the, you know.
Yeah.
And then he went to the doctor and says, is it my Achilles heel?
Snapping your Achilles. Basketball players, football players, that's gotta be the most painful thing. Anyway, but different than Led Zeppelin, this band, I've just scratched the surface on this band. I just, and from the few songs that I knew going into this channel, and now this one, it's like, give me more. You know, there's got to be a treasure trove of Roxy music going to keep Chris and I happy. We're hoping there's a lot of Roxy music fans out there that are just going to flock to our chat channel so we can all have a blast.
We're going to find out there's a lot more, I think, fans of their stuff. So I'm really glad you liked it. This is good. I always like to hear that, but you got to be genuine.
So hope everyone enjoyed that. And if you did, please hit the like button and subscribe if you haven't done so already. And Chris, any last words?
No.
All right. So we'll see you. We'll see you guys on the next episode of Into the Music.
See you all.